Good afternoon, folk. Just before the wedding begins, I just need to remind everybody you have to wear masks. They are recommended to wear while in church. You can, the singing is allowed, but the masks will have to be worn as well, unless you have an exam, you're exempt from wearing them.
Thank you.
Would the congregation please stand? Blessed are they who come in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. O give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Good afternoon, you are very welcome to St. McCartan's Cathedral for this very special day for Richard and Jeanette. May I welcome you all here if they're in person, and may I welcome all those who are joining us online and to those who will watch it online at a later stage. It's a great pleasure as the Dean of the Cathedral here to marry Richard, a member of the Select Vestry, and Jeanette, a member of the Mothers' Union. It's very unusual to have a member of the Select Vestry marry a member of the Mothers' Union, because normally they don't be closely involved with church, but may I say that Richard and Jeanette are very closely involved with church in all spheres of his life. So we pray that God will bless their time together. Just a couple of announcements. One is that you keep social distance unless you're in family bubbles, and they would continue to wear masks during the service. We're allowed to sing, but the masks do need to be worn unless you have an exemption. And feel free to sit or stand, whatever your circumstances may be. Our opening hymn is, the greeting, "The Lord be with you. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them." Our opening hymn number 366, "Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven."
Thank you.
congregation may be seated. We have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Jeanette Wilson and Richard George Cochrane, to ask his blessing on them and to share in their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was himself a guest at a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and through his Spirit he is with us now. The Scriptures set before us marriage as part of God's creation and a holy mystery, in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives, they shall be united in that love as Christ is united with his church. Marriage was ordained that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in plenty and in need, in sorrow and in joy. It's intended that with delight and tenderness they may know each other in love, through the joy of their bodily union they may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. In marriage, husband and wife begin a new life together in the community. It's a permanent commitment that all should honour. It must not be undertaken carelessly, lightly or selfishly, but by God's help, with reverence and responsibility, respect and the promise to be faithful. This is a way of life created and hallowed by God that Richard and Jeanette are now about to begin. They will each give their consent to the other. They will join hands and exchange solemn vows. In token of this, they will give and receive rings. Therefore, in this their wedding day, we pray with them that, strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose of the whole of their earthly life together. Richard and Jeanette now light two candles, symbolizing God's light and hope shining through their individual lives. Point the place, Richard. Good one. We bow our heads. Almighty God, through your Son, Jesus Christ, you sent the Holy Spirit to be the life and light of all your people. Open the hearts of these your servants to the riches of his grace, that they may bring forth the fruit of the Spirit in love and joy and peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The first reading is taken from Proverbs 3, verses 5 to 8. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It will be health to your flesh and strength to your bones. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Psalm 136, and we say it on alternate lines. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Give thanks to God of gods. Give thanks to the Lord of lords. To him alone does great wonders. Who by his understanding made the heavens. Who spread out the earth upon the waters. Who made the great lights. The sun to govern the day. The moon and the stars to govern the night. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The second reading is from 1 Corinthians 13, verses 1 to 13. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, And if I have a faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part, but when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. But when I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see but a poor reflection, as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now with these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We stand for the gospel reading. Hear the gospel of our Saviour Christ according to St. John chapter 15, beginning at verse 9. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept the Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and your joy may be complete. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Would the congregation all in the bridal party be seated? Here we are, Richard and Jeanette. This is, I think, the third attempt, but we've made it this time. due to unforeseen circumstances, we have arrived at the big day. And this, no doubt, is a very joyful day, not only for the both of you, but for the whole family, and indeed for this whole congregation here at St. McCartan's. So every day brings its joys and sometimes brings its sorrows as well. And to help you through the bad times as well as the good times, Jesus assures us that joined to him, if we abide in his love and keep his commands, your joy will be complete. Your earthly joy is complete now, but your whole life, your heavenly joy, will be complete if you keep in contact with the Lord all the days of your life. He never promised to leave us nor forsake us, and he'll be with us to the end of time. And that's my prayer for you today, that as you join together as husband and wife, you will stay joined to the Lord, and may the Lord richly bless you both now and in the days ahead. God bless you both. Now I'm going to ask the congregation to stand. I present you with this common prayer that you will hold dear to it and use it as a format for your prayer life both now and in the days ahead. The vows you are about to take are to be made in the name of God, who is judge of all, and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you know any reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Richard George, will you take Jeanette to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and care for her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Jeanette, will you take Richard George to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and care for him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man? I, Richard George.
I, Richard George.
Take you, Jeanette.
Take you, Jeanette.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us depart.
Till death us depart.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
I, Jeanette,
take you, Richard George,
to be my husband,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health,
till
love and to cherish,
till
death us depart,
according to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow. Heavenly Father, may these rings be to Jeanette and Richard symbols of unending love and faithfulness to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day. He can't see her finger with the glasses on. I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body.
I honor you.
And all that I have.
I share with you.
In the name of God.
Father, Son.
And Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Will it go on?
Wet it.
Yes, it's on. Here we are. I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage.
With my body.
I honor you.
And all that I have.
I share with you. In the name of God.
Father, Son.
And Holy Spirit. Amen. Have you got it on? I can assure you they're now married. The two rings together. In the presence of God and before this congregation, Jeanette and Richard have given their consent. They've made their marriage vows to each other. By the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, therefore, in the name of God, I pronounce your husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Yes, there you go. You've pulled up. He says he's on lipstick now. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may live together in faith and love, and receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. And a couple pray together.
O God, our Father,
we thank
you for uniting our lives and giving us to each other in the fulfillment of love. Watch over us at all times, guide and protect us, and give us faith and patience, that as we hold each other's hands in yours, we may draw strength from you and from each other through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Turn around. Now, will you, the family and friends of Jeanette and Richard, support them and encourage them in their married life together?
Amen.
Come on, mate. They now light the marriage candle symbolizing the union of their lives together. Don't burn the place, Richard. We join together in the acclamations. Blessed are you, Heavenly Father. Blessed are you, Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed are you, Holy Spirit of God. Blessed be the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. You be seated, or please be seated. Would you all be seated except the bridal party? Almighty God, giver of life and love, bless Jeanette and Richard who have now joined in marriage. Grant them wisdom and devotion in their life together. May they each be to the other a strength in need, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. So unite their wills in your will, and their spirits in your spirit, that they may live and grow together in love and peace all the days of their life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Eternal, true and loving Father, in marriage you make your servants one. May their life together witness to your love in this troubled world. May unity overcome division, forgiveness heal injury, and joy triumph over sorrow. We remember with thankfulness our relatives and friends departed this life in your faith and fear, and we pray that we may share with them the joys of your eternal kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And the couple pray together.
God of tenderness and strength, you have brought our paths together and led us to this day. Go with us now as we travel through good times, through trouble or through change. Bless our home, our partings and our meetings. Make us worthy of each other's best and tender with each other's dreams, trusting in our love in Jesus Christ. Amen.
And we join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all whom you love this day and forevermore. Amen. The hymn 634, Love Divine, All Love Excelling.
together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, oh, bind us together with love. There is only one God, there is only one King, there is only one body, that is why we sing. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, oh, bind us together with love. Faithful in the glory of God, purchased by his precious Son, burn with the right to be clean, for Jesus the victory has won. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, oh, bind us together with love. You are the family of God, you are the promise divine, you are God's chosen desire, you are the glorious you are. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, oh, bind us together with love.
Thank you. Ha ha ha.